really is. It's just the idea that like we're all struggling, no matter what it looks like on the outside. If you're like scrolling through someone's feed or you watch them on YouTube, just because they don't share the struggles doesn't mean they're not going through it.
You can't have the good days without the bad days. And you also can't have growth without the bad days either.
And like, I'm so anxious right now. Whew. All right. What's up, y'all? Welcome or welcome back to the channel. I feel so scripted. I want this to be a very brutally honest vlog. I want it to be kind of just like a chain of consciousness. Is that the word? No, stream of consciousness. Wow. About perfectionism and getting out of your comfort zone and, you know, doing something even when it scares you. Because quite literally, it's 12:30 right now on a Sunday. I want to head into Manhattan just to have a fun, leisurely day, you know, where I'm just kind of out and about exploring. I want to get coffee. I want to try. I have like two bucket list things that I haven't done yet that I really want to do, and that is get a cookie from Levain. I don't know how to pronounce it properly. This bakery. It's really popular. They have amazing cookies, apparently. Supposedly the best in Manhattan, so I haven't done that yet, so I want to do that. And I want to get pizza from Bleeker Street Pizza, because I haven't done that yet either. And just kind of walk around, maybe take some photos. But I've been overthinking it. And literally even since last night, I was like thinking about doing this last night. I was like, oh, I should make a video tomorrow. And I was anxious about it. Just like looking at like different spots I wanted to go to. And yeah, I don't know. I just want to be honest and real and open. And like, I'm so anxious right now. Specifically because I'm just gonna go have a good day and that's it. But vlogging it, like, I want to vlog it and I'm excited to vlog it, but I'm afraid of, you know, I don't know. What am I even afraid of? Maybe it's just because I haven't really done it before. Basically what's happening right now is that I'm in the position before I'm about to do something that I'm uncomfortable with. And my brain is like telling me everything that could go wrong to like try to stop me from doing it. And I just know I have to power through. And it's gonna end up being a great day. I just have to do it. It's so crazy. I'm just somebody who gets very stuck in my comfort zone, like my bubble, even though I just moved to New York still. So I just need to go out. I just need to go do it. So that's what we're gonna do today. We're gonna head into Manhattan. I live in Brooklyn. And we're just gonna do it. That's all we can do, is feel the fear and do it anyway. So, gonna get dressed. Actually, I am already dressed. I have to put a sweatshirt on, jacket. It's like 60 degrees with, it feels like temperature at 54. So fall is on the way. I think it actually is here. It's October 8th, 9th. October 8th, so. All right, I'm stalling. I've stalled enough this morning. Just been ruminating, like thinking all day, so. Alright, let's do it. I actually have to pack my bag too. I'm not gonna bring a lot, I just need like batteries, water. I hate leaving the house without water. I don't know. I don't know why. Because I don't feel like buying it. It's just like annoying to have to buy water. I'm gonna bring my film camera too, because I kinda just wanna take some photos, and that's it. And then I have to bring this camera too, with the mic, so. Should I do a tote bag, or a sling bag? Literally put everything in a tote bag, and then switched it to a sling bag, and then switched it to a backpack. Alright, now we're ready to go.
Already,
is this recording? Yeah.
I feel so much better just by getting out just by leaving the house, it's always the anticipation that's the worst part. It's always the anticipation leading up to doing something new or something different that's the worst part. And once you actually do it, it's just busy street, there's people walking by and I feel weird. But once you actually do the thing, you realize it's just, the fear is all in your head. It's so crazy. I thought today was gonna go like wrong if I was recording and like, I was gonna regret it. So far, it's been great. And finally got it. I secured the cookie. I've wanted to try this thing for so long. I've been seeing it on YouTube forever and on Instagram and all that, so. And I also had to get a coffee with it. So from here, we're gonna head to Washington Square Park and just hang out and see what else happens. I feel so much better though. Popped a squat, found a bench at Washington Square Park. I always try to find spots where there's not a lot of people around, but I can't always do that either, so I have to sit down and I have to hold this camera out and I have to know that people are seeing it, and that's okay. Like, I'm not doing anything bad, I'm literally vlogging, so it's just gonna take time to get used to it, and that's it. The thing I was thinking about too is that I wanna be more consistent on YouTube between photography videos and vlogging. And that means I'm gonna have to pick up the camera on days that I'm not 100% also, and when things aren't always great, because that's normal. Not every single day is gonna be sunshine and roses, and that's totally fine, because that's life. You can't have the good days without the bad days, and you also can't have growth without the bad days either, because you're not gonna learn, you're not gonna grow if you're not putting yourself out there and diving into the uncomfortable stuff. Because that's just unfortunately not how it works. You have to get outside your bubble to learn new things and grow and for new things to happen, so it's not easy, but it's extremely worth it because, you know, it's so rewarding when you start to feel yourself getting more comfortable with the things that you weren't comfortable with before. And the only way to get there is by doing the things, as I just said, so. Moral of the story. If I want to be consistent on YouTube, I also have to show up on the days where I'm feeling anxious and I'm feeling stressed, and, you know, as long as I'm up for it. Like, I do want to say, obviously there's time where you do need breaks and you need to step away, but today, no, like, I was just anxious, but I still wanted to film, so here we are. This is also decaf because caffeine gives me anxiety. Here we go. Get out of town. Look at this. Look at it. Unbelievable. It's crunchy, and then the inside is soft and it's warm. Man, that's too good. I'm just gonna walk around the park for a little bit and just hang out and enjoy it. It's so perfect right now. It feels like fall. This guy's playing drums and a saxophone over there. It's just so cozy. Something sick and unexpected happens that somebody I went to high school with, he's been doing photography and stuff. He goes on tour with like bands and takes photos for them, which is really cool. We didn't really talk in high school because like I was super shy and he was kind of doing his own thing. But he's here now today, this weekend in Bushwick. And he messaged me and was like, yo, if you want to meet up. I think he's on his way here, so that'll be cool to like check in. I don't know if I'm gonna put that in the video or not, but that's it. We're just rolling with the punches today.
really is. It's just the idea that like we're all struggling, no matter what it looks like on the outside. If you're like scrolling through someone's feed or you watch them on YouTube, just because they don't share the struggles doesn't mean they're not going through it.
Do you ever feel like an outcast from like everyone in our high school? Like in the sense
of 100%.
Like since you're trying to do like, for me personally, I always felt, I guess fear sometimes fuels a lot of my work in the sense. So it's like me trying to prove a point that I'm good enough. Like everyone has a conventional job, I guess, and like it's like safe and practical.
Right.
And then like we're trying to do this thing that's very against the grain and unconventional. Mm-hmm. And it's kind of in some ways looked down upon.
Right.
In some,
it's different. And, yeah, and it's like risky route.
Yeah, exactly. That's like something I'm thinking about a lot. Is like maybe if I do all these jobs, I'm actually good enough to be. Maybe good enough as that person that is an engineer or something. Like right. I always feel like not qualified.
You'll be like accepted.
Yeah, accepted. Like, exactly. Yeah, I guess deep down I'm looking for acceptance.
Right. And that's a tough one because I mean, especially like you said, I'm grateful that I like have a full time job that I'm like working with. But that acceptance, unfortunately, like we're the only ones that can give that to ourselves, which is like the hardest part. I mean, I'm still learning this too. But, like. At the end of the day, we're the only ones that can give us ourselves that acceptance, and it's like finding out how to do that, I think, is like the hard part. I mean, yeah, just like what I was saying before, like if my reels don't get the reaction that I'm like imagining, like if I post something I'm really proud of and it gets like no comments, sometimes I assume I'm being annoying, when in reality it's like, no, you don't know what the person, you don't know, somebody could just be scrolling past it and not think anything of
it,
or they might just not comment on it.
But also, like, you're proud of that. Like,
right, that's what matters. Yeah.
Exactly.
It's like, you're proud of it. It was fun to make. It's like, you're doing something that you believe in just because you enjoy it. And it's like, that's, at the end of the day, that's what should matter.
You know how many times I've made, like, a design or something for somebody, and, like, I was like, this is sick. This is so cool. And then, like, they send you, like, so many notes. Like, this doesn't look, like, this is not what we wanted or whatever.
Yeah.
And then you get in your head and you question, like, your self-worth.
Yes.
Or, like, I put a lot of weight into my work. And,
yes.
like, I'm trying to come to terms with the fact that my personal worth is not equated to my successes in my job. Who's to say if you went cross country and lived in a van that you're not just as good as a person as the person that works on Wall Street kind of thing?
Right, yeah, definitely. It's like the money ties a certain worth, and it's like the fear of that, the
exactly.
acceptance, the judgment. It's like at the end of the day, you could be so much happier than the person working on Wall Street if they, because they could be wishing, oh, I wish I could just get in a van and go somewhere. It's like, we never know what anybody else is really thinking. All we can do is care about like how we're feeling.
Exactly.
Man,
that was insane. That was such a good conversation. And it tied in so well with the whole point of this video, which is just pushing through the anxiety and the uncomfort, the discomfort to do what you want to be doing in your life. So Ryan, shout out to you. I just want to say, I am so glad I literally ended up coming out. And it's crazy to think I almost didn't, because I was afraid and I was uncomfortable. One of the reasons I was afraid specifically was like how I was gonna record, if I was gonna record like going into these, like I'm gonna go to Bleeker Street Pizza right now. And I was afraid of like recording inside the restaurant and like missing the shot, not doing it, because I was afraid, like thinking ahead, trying to figure out how I'm going to solve problems that didn't even exist yet. I keep looking at the screen instead of into the lens, I'm sorry. I have to get better about that. But I'm so glad I came out. That conversation with my friend was so good. We just had so much in common as far as what we're going through with like overthinking and being afraid of, you know, making a mistake or like wondering if we're doing what we're supposed to be doing and doing it the right way. It's just, I think creative people and just people in general, we think so much about what could go wrong before we actually
Stop.
Even do anything. But we're not going to grow unless we do the things that make us uncomfortable. So it's just so important. I also just took a bunch of portraits at Washington Square Park that I'm really happy with. I think I'll see how they come out when I get the film developed. Just a good day overall that could have been missed if I gave in to the anxiety. Just crazy.
Yeah.
Man, Bleeker Street pizza slaps. It's definitely, it's worth the hype. Might be my new favorite, to be honest. I don't know, Village Square Pizza is still probably my favorite, but Bleeker Street was really good too. I need to find a spot to like sit and debrief. So hold on. Today has just been so good for me mentally. Getting out of my comfort zone, I just feel so much better, especially compared to this morning when I was just like swirling in my head. Wow, really dark. Hold on. Something that I say all the time that I'll say here is that the life you want and the life you're looking for is waiting for you just on the other side of your comfort zone. And it's literally, it's so true. It's hard to remember that when you're spiraling like I was this morning, but just know that you're so much more capable than you think you are. We just have to make that push, take the leap to just to get out there and start doing the thing that we're afraid of, because the anticipation is always so much scarier than the thing itself. That's all. Thank you.